We have a New England team kill, two of the best from their region. You guys know him well, a shoe-in for one of the best players in the world. Repping Zero Suit Samus, the only man doing it at this level in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. I'd like to welcome to the stage Panda Global Mars! And of course, his opponent, the primary purveyor of Kool-Aid options. This man plays like nobody else. He plays a whole bunch of wacky characters, but we could probably expect to see one of these top tiers coming out from him. I'm speaking, of course, about a fellow resident of Massachusetts to Mars. That's Daijobu Laid! All right, both of these guys are super sick in this game. If you've never watched them before, you're in for a treat for sure. But guys, before we throw it over, back to the casters, back to the match, I'd like you all to let the thousands of people at home, knowing how we say what's up in New York, let them know. Yeah! All right, guys, I'm out. Aussie, Ajax, you got it.
Damn, what an intro. Yeah, what can you say, man? I felt the yurt inside of me. I wanted to shout out to the top of my lungs.
You know, I definitely had to hold back a little bit, so we didn't go
scream into the mic.
Rest in peace, any mic, headphone users.
Oh, 100%.
Now, like he pointed out, this one hurts for me a bit because those two right up there are two of the New England's finest that we have playing. You have Mars and you have Laid. Mars, very large win record over Laid, regularly taking out W's over him at Thursday night fights every single Thursday. But Laid does have some W's as well his pocket under that. And he plays a very strong Lucina. He's going to be playing very patient, trying to bait out Mars, but Mars loves when people try to slow down on him.
Yeah, and Laid's actually was not fated to get up here to top bait at all. So it's kind of like a natural surprise, especially fighting against Mars, who was not supposed to be on loser's side, you know, taking an early defeat to Leon.
Yeah, unfortunately for Laid, he actually usually ends up losing pretty early when he goes out of region, so this is definitely one of his better performances coming out. Right now you see they're just throwing out hitboxes, trying to feel each other out, looking for the first opening.
Could be the opening gambit that he's looking for. Trying to get that spike off stage against Lucina. This could be really tricky, right? When you're trying to get Lucina off stage like that, she has a pretty strong recovery. It's really hard to deal with, but you know what? Who cares? You can run up there, catch the tech in, get the up B. Not enough to get the kill just yet. And I like these baits that he's going for off stage, right? Trying to force him to roll onto the stage.
Yeah, usually you have to respect all of the Dolphin Slash attempts, but the thing is, Mars doesn't really care about respecting anybody off stage. He will always make sure you feel uncomfortable, consistently punishing these neutral get-ups. It's not something you want to do too often. Probably going to look for a roll here instead, going for a neutral get-up yet again.
Laid is having so much trouble getting back to this stage. Found an opening with an up smash. Just ran right in front of him. Got it out, but still back on the ledge. The ledge trapping coming out from Mars
and whenever you're
is out of this world.
Whenever you're trying to box your way out of the corner against Mars, he's usually putting a retreating hitbox or a grab with that tether grab. He's trying to stuff you out before you even get the momentum to get back to center stage. Trying to look for a spot dodge there instead of just going for a regular hit.
There he goes, just catches him with the up smash, trying to catch out a jump as well. It's going to be the first stock going to Mars. Now there's a lot on the line for Mars here, right? He's never won a tournament beyond a C tier.
Yeah,
and this is Defend the North, I thought was a B tier. I think it might be an A, dog. Yeah. There's a lot of competition.
It's
we'll
very possible. You know, we haven't gotten full confirmation, but this might end up being an A tier event.
Sword gave us some hush-hush info. Don't tell no one.
I know. We'll find out a little bit more later. We'll tell you that. But a big key factor to the way that this match is going to progress is how long does it take for Laid to close out these stocks? Because Mars with momentum is so dangerous, but completely untouched, hitting him with the shield breaker, taking the stock out.
Fantastic start for Laid. Okay, going for a counter, expecting Mars to be a little overzealous with the aggression. And you're going to see up tilts coming out from Lucina. That's a really good anti-air against his opponent. To be able, whenever they're just kind of in the air, especially the likes of Mars and Zero Suit, who likes being in the air.
And you see that he's going to be fishing to get those flip kicks too. He's played against Mars so much, he knows the routes usually, but Mars changes it up so often, it's hard to keep track of him. Keeping this game dead even, but finally forcing him to the ledge. What's he going to do about this? Gets hit away with the up tilt.
He's hoping for that roll in. You saw him looking hungrily for that roll in. Try to get that stun, but good answer from Laid. Every single time you see Laid getting pushed off stage like that, it's such a struggle.
It's a key for stage positioning between these two. They want to make sure they hold momentum. Gonna get hit by the back air though. Now he has to choose the correct route.
You
gonna get
so
by
deep
with the air dodge, almost getting hit on the neutral get up.
You gotta be so careful of those back airs. And those heels are weigh a ton.
Yeah, and that Nair also on get up as well. Lucina, one of the best ledge trapping characters in the business, trying to look for the roll, but Mars going the other way, reading the right call, but he's not going to die off the up smash.
And that was a hard read from Lee. You saw him go for a down smash of all choices. Like, he was trying to end that stock.
And now he's got to keep that in his back pocket. He's like, all right, he teched away last time. What's the option following up? Am I going to commit next time? I almost died to it.
I love these retreating back airs from Mars. Trying to play it safe, calls out the flip kick.
That's what we talked about before.
And he goes in further!
The moment that he dug too low, he's like, all right, you have only had one choice. You have to jump here, you have to flip kick. I'm going to go meet you before you even get to.
And Mars was looking for a jump out of shield. You saw him dancing around Late's block, just hoping to find some sort of answer. The up big, big punish coming out from Late, potential edge guard. No, Mars finds his way back to center stage, connects the back air, gets a stock, one stock apiece in this first game of top eight.
You look at those last two interactions. Mars went at him while he recovered high multiple times, never threw out a hitbox, trying to see what he would do. That time pulling it out, conditioning him to think that he was not gonna hit him.
That was a scary situation for Late. He had to go for a dolphin slash immediately because he ate his double jump. It was a quick burst option that Mars wasn't expecting. I like that he got a big conversion off of that grab.
Bursting is definitely Mars' favorite thing. You know, he plays on retreat a lot, but when he gets a hold advantage, kind of like what Kool-Aid's doing right now, they usually capitalize big. New England loves getting a hold of a stock and trying to delete it as quick as possible.
Okay, not going to let him go center stage. Hungry again, forward tilt to keep him mid-air.
That dash cancel forward tilt, almost hitting him. Oh, this should cost him, though. He's going to get the flip kick.
DI? Marsh. No, he's dead. Never mind. Forget what I said. He exploded.
Right at the corner there, not too much he could have done there. Out of a hopeful maybe fallout. But you saw Mars actually shaking his head at the end. He felt like he was not playing optimally to what he normally does in this match. Kool-Aid playing very, very solid right now.
Honestly, even though Kool-Aid lost that first game, he was playing extremely on point. I felt like his edge guards were really good. Getting back to the stage against Mars in the beginning looked really rough.
Yep.
But later on in the game, he was able to get back to center stage. And he put up quite a fight, and it was just that missed air dodge. You saw that air dodge from Mars at the very end before he got back onto the stage and got that confirmed kill. And that's what's scary against Mars, dude. He can kill you at a disadvantage.
Yeah, and the thing is, too, when you come to these matchups where you played against somebody for so long, especially at this level, you have to layer your mix-up game. You can't keep doing the same thing over and over again, otherwise you're going to get blown up. And you see that, even though Mars normally does so well, he's going to get destroyed on the first stock. Kool-Aid closing that out so fast.
Blade knew exactly where Mars was going to be that whole time. He was going to recover low right afterward, just went for a safe Nair, be able to get that, solidify that kill. And Lucina can afford to go off deep in case he whiffs. You know, Lucina has a really fantastic recovery.
That's great for confidence, too. If you could start to get in Mars' head early and make it feel like, okay, now he's starting to call me out, I got to play a little bit more defensive and change it up, then Kool-Aid could start to change his own pace. Trying to look for the flip kick there, not getting anything, though.
Whenever you see Mars like on the ground, you see him trying to space out these forward tilts. Good conversion. Actually got a kill off of that back air, too.
And for Mars, that works out so well. Only taking 25%, going into this next stock, and he's evening it right back up. You never have a large lead against Zero Suit the moment he gets a hold of you.
Mars, the conversion king. We got a grab going in the wrong direction. Not too big of a punish from Late again. I think he was like, he had a little bit of doubt in what he wanted to go for a punish there.
Yeah, I think he was kind of surprised that he even got by with that roll there. So by the time he tried to go for the down tilts, maybe set up for tech chases, didn't press the trigger early enough. Not going to get hit by the down smash rising with that fair either.
Crossed him up with the down air, pushing him back to the edge of the stage. I like his forward airs are coming out a little hair too slow in order to try to actually get these punishes against Mars. Stuck.
Yeah, and you see that Kool-Aid starting to pull out the shield breaker. He knows that he's got to throw out these short up fairs to condition Mars into shield. Mars normally not staying in one place all the time. He's going to get directly under him and get that up smash.
How many times is he going to land up smash against Late and get these kills? Running up against him, not showing no fear, expecting Late to just jump.
Yeah, you got to put those anti-air options out there consistently. You got to make him feel uncomfortable. And now Kool-Aid not looking too frightened after that either. He's still going in.
My man is stoic. Not denying Mars this stage presence. Okay, gets the parry on it, but again, too slow. If you just were done, I think he was deciding on where Mars was going to land afterwards, and he wanted to just go for a guaranteed punish. But it's so safe. Maybe go for a forward tilt instead.
Yeah, probably anticipating that he was going to fade away after the bounce, even off of the parry. But because of that, ended up costing him probably a stock. But even so, taking 56%, trying to just find his answer, trying to chase him down, but Mars not giving it to him.
You cannot give Mars an inch, man. He will take it a mile. There we go. Nair out of shield, just a basic hit. Going to be able to get that kill. I mean, Lucina's out of shield options are so quick in the air.
Like, yeah, both of them, really. You have to respect being on shield all the time between Boost Kick and Dolphin Slash.
And not only is it quick, it also has a lot of range. Mm-hmm. You know, that sword, that parallel Falchion, really big.
And you see people like Mr. E using it so much. Kool-Aid just barely getting by through that fair there. Again, last stock, pretty much last hit situation for both of them. 86%, definitely kill potential for that is his jump. No, actually still had to jump. And he makes some air dodge. He's going to get by. Marsh trying to chase him down, but he gets back on.
Blade was expecting an aggressive defensive option from Mars. Again, he went off for the counter. Nice call out, waits for the roll, goes for the boost kick.
That walk back and forth just to get him to feel like he was gonna do something. And as soon as he moved, Mars could have just stayed in shield. If he didn't move at all, he would have been fine. Trade that situation, nothing's gonna happen. But because he put himself in that spot, up B, his reaction time is so fast.
He literally put the fear in him. When you're stuck on the edge of the stage like that, holding shield, you don't have many options at your repertoire because you don't have stage control, because you're on the edge. What are you gonna do? Jump or roll? Usually, those are going to be your two options to try to get out of that corner. Mars was fiending for that roll. Yeah, managed to find it.
This whole match is pretty textbook to how a lot of these things normally go. Whenever Kool-Aid's feeling good, he tends to get very close, but doesn't have the ability to close out the stock. And he's had a couple chances, but Mars has just gotten by. Mars is the one who's been able to keep his confidence in those high-pressure situations to close out those stocks.
Now, these guys usually only play best two of three sets whenever they play, correct?
No,
they always do 3 of 5?
Yeah, no, we do 3 out of 5. Since
I'm sorry.
We don't have a certain Pac-Man and a certain Wii Fit that made us switch to that.
Yeah. Oh!
And also the matches end relatively quick when you have things like that happen.
We got one of those Pac-Mans in top 8 later on, but let's focus on the set. Still, we still got the dancing Blade coming out, taking on some more damage. But honestly, if I was a betting man, I would say Mars has all the control here. He got yet another spike at that low of percent.
Yeah, and you know, Kool-Aid's gonna just take a second on the Angel platform to try and recollect, trying to go for a fair, and Mars ended up stealing a stock on him, and now things are just kind of derailing out of place.
They were playing patient. Wait. Nice. Yeah, Mars is like, kick him out of there. Give him another. He went for it.
And on that spot, too, every trade is positive. If he keeps hitting the nairs away with F-Tilt, he has stage position, and Kool-Aid's taking even more damage. He's 2 stocks up, so it's all worth it for him.
And you see that down air coming out from Mars. Like, a lot of players would never like think to do something like that in a tech situation. It's such an unorthodox option, but that's Mars' playstyle. He is one of the most unorthodox players out there that makes it work.
Yes.
You give my man 3 options, he's picking the 4th.
Kool-Aid's literally standing still, has not
moved.
Kool-Aid just not moving at all, just trying to like get a parry to kind of get Mars to do something. I don't know if he's just kind of writing it off at this point, but
they both just stood still. They're betting. And in classic Mars fashion, going for the down air off stage, doesn't care. He has 3 stocks to play with, so why not? Late is stuck.
Yeah, I think
good tech.
I'm pretty sure at this point Kool-Aid is kind of just giving it up. He was just kind of fading around, staying on the ledge, trying to give him like the intentional suicide. Like, I don't want to do it myself, and I let you just go ahead and take the W. I'm just gonna let you get the boost kick or the flip kick or something along the way. But that was a bit rough after taking that jump on him on that second stock. Everything just kind of like all of the drive to win got taken away from him.
And I mean, that's the looking of a top 3 player in the world, if you ask me. Panda Global Mars coming out here with a 3-0 victory over Laid. One of his companions getting a team kill from New England.
Yeah, if you're betting man at all, if you want to talk about the ranks that are upcoming with the PGR.
This is the moment. This is the moment.
Yeah, right there. Both of them just staring each other down.
One more time, Devin. I want to watch that in slow-mo. Just like how long they just like stared at each other right here.
It was just that moment. It's like, hey, you know what?
It's like, what's going to happen here?
You know what? Hey, Mars, I'm just saying.
What's up? How's it going? How's it going?
You got it. You
tried it. So what happened is we're just standing still for forward smash.
That happened so fast, I didn't even realize he actually tried to forward smash him.
There was such a delay. Like, that's what caught me off guard. And you saw him go for that parry because he thought Mars was going to be like, go for like an aggressive option, maybe a jab, maybe a forward tilt.
It's like the heroic sacrifice at the end of a movie when you got to look at your friend like, look, go ahead. I'll stop them.
Yeah.
And it felt hurt. It hurt me right here.
So that was the New England set. So now we're going to move on into the New York.